Okay, welcome back from the break. Thank you, Balajit, for the beautiful practice, and also the wonderful description of how our nervous system, how parts of our nervous system work to keep us protected. While you were sharing all that, it reminded me of something that I've been, a way that I've been relating to, what I think I'm doing. So I'm gonna say a few things, and then I'm gonna guide us in a metta bhavana practice. Playing around with how we might bring the four questions into that practice, into the practice of friendliness, loving kindness. So yeah, it's interesting, the longer we practice, how one of the things that I find really helpful is to keep sort of checking in with what it is that I think I'm doing, and then updating the story I tell myself about what I think I'm doing. So at the moment, what I think I'm doing is, and actually while I'm talking about this, maybe it might be helpful to share what I thought I was doing when I first came along, because it was an interesting moment when I realized that it wasn't quite about that. So when I first came along, what I thought I was doing was looking for ways to work with my mind so that I could be a better person. And at some point that fell away. The need to be a better person fell away. Not that that's not important, but I think I realized that it was much bigger than that somehow. So it's not that there's anything wrong with wanting to be a better person, but from a point of view of striving for awakening, like it goes beyond that. It goes beyond that. And now what I tell myself, the story I tell myself about what it is I think I'm doing, is that I'm doing two things simultaneously. So it's a both and. So the both and is that I'm both learning to trust more and more deeply and fully my true nature. So who and what I truly am. Beyond states of egoic clinging or pushing away or numbing out. So there's lots of different language for this: the open dimension of being, who and what we truly are, the natural state, fully awakened, whatever, the bodhicitta. So I'd encourage you to find your own language for this. For me, I'm really finding the awakening factors helpful. Like, what if I really believed that those states, those qualities of calm, joy, wisdom, compassion, love. So the awakening factors and their offshoots. A fully aware, completely open being. And again, I'll just quote the Parabeda Sutta, you know, that final awakening factor of equanimity. So being someone for whom within me there's nothing that I reject as not mine, and nothing that I accept as mine. So beyond acceptance and rejection. So yeah, so I'd encourage you to find your own articulation for who and what we truly are, or what we think we might truly be. We have to edge into it, don't we? Because it can be hard. These ideals can feel so far away. So there's this, yeah, so that's the first part of the both and. So learning to trust more and more in my true nature, and in the true nature of others, the ground of our being, while also simultaneously and in the service of deepening that trust, having a deep respect and honoring of this body, this nervous system, who is arriving in this moment with all of her many flaws, and appreciating that that's where I am. That's my conditioning. That's my inheritance, my karmic inheritance. That's the very material, raw material I have to work with. And that's beautiful. It's all mine. It doesn't belong to anyone else but me. It's uniquely, perfectly mine. In that no one else can liberate me from it but me. So others might help lovingly, patiently. And then the question for me is like, how do I do that? How do I honor and respect this body, this nervous system? How I'm conditioned, what's showing up now? And so much can be revealed in all of the resources that we've been sharing on this retreat so far. And then one really, really important, super helpful way is just deeply trusting in and learning how to ground in metta. Tenderness for myself and others. Because we're all in this together. We're all both, you know, we all have both the potential for awakening and the raw material that we're working with right now. And sometimes there can be a big, what seems like a big gaping hole between the two things. And other times, maybe it feels a bit closer. And I think I said yesterday that a lot of the work is also so much of practice is about holding that tension. So not setting ourselves up against the tension, not rejecting the tension or seeing it as bad or a problem, but really learning how to be in the tension of the space between the ideal and what's happening now, what's showing up now, often as a result of our learned habits that get held in the nervous system. So so one of the things I also like to bring to mind when I'm articulating this for myself is language that I've borrowed from the American social justice activist who also is a doula. So her name's Adrienne Marie Brown. I'll put her name in the chat. You can look her up. She's fantabulous, a beautiful being. I'm so glad to be awake on the earth with her while she's alive, sharing the world with this amazing being. And she said, oh, it's not Mary Brown. Damn you, autocorrect. It's Marie Brown, two E's. So when she was talking about working as a doula, so a doula is someone who supports women in the birthing process. She said that one of the most profound lessons she learned working as a doula was that so much of life is about learning how to engage with the tension without indulging the drama. So, you know, when something's happening, particularly that's challenging, to bring in that word again in the title of the retreat, can we engage with the tension of that in a creative way without getting kind of sucked into the narratives and the egoic habitual ways of identifying with what's happening? So that's all I'll say about that. And let's practice again. So we'll have about time, my head, math. I'd like to leave some space at the end of this session for inquiry. So about 10 minutes. So yeah, we'll be meditating for about 35 minutes. So go ahead and get yourself set up in a comfortable, supportive posture. Lying down is always an option. And maybe in the spirit of taking care of our bodies, maybe just rather than just habitually going into whatever you normally like, then whatever your like default posture is, just check in with the body, what it needs right now. And if there is a sense that lying down might be more supportive or standing up or some other shape, do that and see how that is. Try something else on. So if you're already in your posture and you feel settled enough, we could take a few deep breaths here just to support a letting go of all the words, all the ideas. You don't have to remember anything. And with each breath, we can remind ourselves that we're here and we're alive. On the out breath, supporting a surrendering to the earth. And on the in breath, really letting the body fully expand into space. And here, let's just spend a little bit of time noticing how it feels to be connected to the earth. So really dropping the awareness down right into all the places that the body is in contact with the cushions, the floor, the chair. And allowing those sensations to really enter into awareness and be fully known and felt. And through these sensations, opening to the qualities of the ground. So supportive to our practice. Stillness, stability, sense of safety, being held. And anything else you notice there? With each breath, allowing these qualities to be drawn up and into the body, permeating the whole of us. And then just taking a little bit of time to notice how the upper body rises out of this firm foundation, or if you're laying down, how the whole of the front of the body can open to space from this place of being held. So feeling space stretching in all directions, as well as above. Sky stretching infinitely outwards. So much space in all directions. And we are also held here. And then in your own time, in your own way, just beginning to notice what is here. And in that noticing, allowing a warm, kind, gentle, tender awareness to meet that, whatever it is. And it may be as we start to open to what's here, there's aspects of our experience that we find more difficult to be with. So here we can begin to get curious about what's it actually like, that pain in the knee or that tender ache in the heart, contraction in the belly, fogginess, whatever it is. Just leaning in gently. How is it? Seeing any habits to kick into story or disconnect from what's happening. Maybe it's easier just to hang out on the edges of what's difficult rather than going straight in. Or perhaps a bit of tending can help, resourcing yourself in some way that you know works for you. How is it now? So there's an opportunity now to bring to mind someone we care for, a good friend. And just like in life, when we meet someone, we meet them with whatever's happening for us. So whatever's going on in the first stage doesn't have to be shut down or turned away from. We just carry it into the next stage. And noticing what's here as we bring our friend to mind. What's here? Seeing what it's like to open to the full complexity of our response to our good friend. Leaning into the feeling tone of what's here, getting curious about how it is. Maybe some things are pleasant, like a warmth or an expansion, a smile across the face. Maybe there's things that are less pleasant. Remembering something confusing, maybe that passed between you, or realizing there's something you haven't shared with them that you've been meaning to. Feeling shame. Whatever's here, just leaning into it, seeing if you can stay with how it is. And your response to it, how you are with what's here. noticing what might become possible that wasn't possible before as we lean into and get curious about how it is and how we are with it. Bringing to mind now someone you don't know so well, you haven't formed much of an opinion of, don't have a sense of strong feelings either way. Doing the best you can to really bring this person fully into your imagination. And just noticing what comes up as you do that, how it is, what's here. So here we might notice what happens as we remind ourselves that this person also, just like us and our good friend, want to be happy and well and free from suffering. Noticing how you respond to that reflection and what becomes possible. So if you've noticed you've gone into stories or distracted by persistent thinking, just appreciating that the system is doing what it needs to do to take care of itself. And noticing what it's like to simply return to this imagined person in our minds, who's real out there in the world right now, doing whatever they're doing, living their life. How does it feel in the body to bring this person to mind and to wish them well? So we're just going to take a moment to notice what's happening in the body and making any movements, shifts, self-touch, opening the eyes, looking around, whatever we need to support presence. And taking care of this very sensitive, tender body. Coming back to our own sense of wellness just now. Being here. And then in your own time and way, beginning to remember someone who we're finding a bit difficult just now. Maybe we've, in our imagination, put them way out on the periphery. And the invitation is to bring them as close to the center as feels possible just now. Center of your imagination. Noticing what's here and how it is when we do that. And in this stage, it can be helpful to ask ourselves what's familiar about how we experience this person. How am I with this person? The way that I perceive and experience them. And is this familiar? And if it is familiar, just spending a bit of time feeling into the sensations of that. And also what else is possible when we don't get carried away by our response. Maybe there's a bit more space or perspective, capacity to see them more fully as a human being who also suffers and wants to be well. So inviting the good friend and the neutral person to join ourselves and the person we're finding a bit difficult in a imagined space of awareness. All four beings here in our minds, in our hearts. As living, breathing people who are good fundamentally, at their core, have goodness, and are also conditioned, have bodies and nervous systems, habits, ways of thinking, speaking, and acting that aren't always skillful, and sometimes are. Complex. How is it to hold that in our hearts, that truth? How is it to simply wish ourselves well? including the retreat. Everyone practicing together this week in this sacred space we've co-created. And then extending even further out to the people we know and love. How is it to bring them to mind with this intention of well-wishing? And then if it's possible, going even further, the whole of humanity. Sharing this one and only planet of ours that we're intimately inseparable from. And all living beings. The whole of life. Striving for wellness, wholeness, healing. We can even include inanimate objects. Who knows? A rock could be alive in its own way. How is it to hold the whole universe in our hearts? So for the last minute here, just releasing any effort. Maybe taking a few deeper breaths and opening. To the ground, sounds, the visual field. Just sitting. And in a moment, I'll ring a bell to mark the end of the practice, and it'll be a little bit of a space to reflect on anything you noticed. And also a chance to share that with the group. So just emerging from the practice in your own way, making whatever movements, stretching, rubbing, caressing to support you. Making any sounds as well. Noticing any tendency to want to snap back into place. Seeing what it might be like to just stay open, stay in that space, that post-meditation. Whatever's here, space. And just spending a moment to just allow yourself to let in what just happened, whatever just happened. Just noticing the effects of the practice. And anything that happened there. Sometimes we can subtly sort of pick and choose what's worth noticing at the end of a practice. And the invitation here is not to judge our experience. You know, in fact, sometimes the very thing we dismiss might be the key to our liberation if we turn towards it and got curious about it. So I want to invite reflections, noticings from the practice. You can drop them in the chat. Thanks, Suzanne, for kicking us off. And you could also come forward if you'd like to just engage in a little inquiry with me about what you noticed there. And the best way to do that is to put the hand in the reactions up. So going to your reactions button and picking that raised hand option, so that I can see you and we can bring you forward with spotlight. Hi, Rosa. Nice to see you here. You're on mute, hun.
Thank you. Sorry. Thanks for the practice. I really enjoyed the meditation and it's kind of noticed, I guess, I found with the neutral person and also the difficult person, I kind of became more aware of things I don't normally notice. Mm. I don't know if they've always been there, if I just, it's something new, I don't know, but I've just never really. With the neutral person, like I felt more, I put someone who was, I've seen on here, so like I'm just connecting to the idea that there is a connection with whatever brought us to this particular retreat in some way. And I felt really moved by that. Like it's, maybe it feels like a way I can connect to people I don't know generally, like connecting to like that, I guess, shared humanity, even with people you don't necessarily have much in common with, you're both still alive and breathing and here now. And sometimes that's enough to have more of a metaphor connection with someone. And also with the difficult person, like I've been really thinking about the both and just thinking, you know, don't have to like you and that's okay. And I can still want the best for you. And I mean, it's not that's new information to me, but it's, I feel like I'm feeling it on a different level. And not just for that person who I particularly picked, but like when it was opened out into the fifth stage, like I kind of just really felt that for all the people I don't like. Like, not necessarily in a profound way, but like, it was just easier to have a different understanding of that idea. And hopefully, well, I don't know what's going to happen next, but probably best not to hold on to that. But yeah.
Yeah.
So that was really good.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, really appreciating all you just shared with us there. Thank you so much. So yeah, this recognizing, oh, there's something a bit new here. And then with the neutral person, yeah, fantastic. Not just the sort of dropping into, oh, what, you know, this feeling so moved by what connected you, but also then like the creative next step was like, oh, I could do that with everyone everywhere at once. Yeah, so that's really, I love the creativity of that, and I'd encourage you to keep feeling into that, not just the intention to do it, but how it feels when you do it. Yeah, and familiarizing yourself with those feelings in the body. And then similarly with what you said about the difficult person, again, just really appreciating how, like, quite spontaneously when you went to the whole world, it was like, oh yeah, those difficult people can be there and I don't have to like them and that's okay. I can still want the best for them. So that both and, oh, I think it's a really good example of that, what I was saying about, you know, sort of trusting in people's true nature and honoring and respecting how we're showing up now, which I won't go into this right now because we only have a minute left of the session. And I think that that has profound implications for our practice of setting boundaries, which we haven't talked about yet on this retreat. And it's such an important practice to both take care of ourselves and others. Yeah. So yeah, like it's a great question. How can we sort of notice and allow it to be okay that we just, there's some people we just don't like, or maybe we don't feel very safe around, and to not let that go into blame and shame. You know, in a way that can even maybe be a doorway into allowing ourselves to also want the best for them. Because usually, I mean, I don't know, you know, it's all of the different complex conditions that come into play that mean that we don't like, you know, we don't have a good feeling for someone, or we don't feel safe enough around them. And one of the things I know in my own practice of this is when I encounter people who are very, very dysregulated, that can be my response, like, oof, it's a lot of chaos and disorganization in the system. How can I sort of recognize that for what it is? And in wanting them to be well, it's also like wanting them to find regulation and wellness within themselves. It's not just for me, it's so that they also can know that peace, that calm. So I say that with kind of a big caution sign, because we don't want to get into like too much of like, oh, I'm going to wish you well so that you won't be so annoying.
I don't do that too.
I think the first 5 years of my metta practice was pretty much a lot of that. It's a stage, isn't it? It's a step towards something. Doesn't need to be judged either. Thank you so much. Yeah, really good to hear from you, Rosa. And yeah, do feel free to, you know, drop any more reflections, like the Padlet's there. So I know we didn't, you know, we don't have time to get around to everyone, and there may be further reflections that come out of the inquiry. So do feel free to use the Padlet for that. And yeah, thank you so much for being here. I'll just, before we close, just want to appreciate also what's been dropped into the chat here. So Suzanne, what's it like to hold the whole universe in your heart? That's a great question. Thank you. Did I say that? I guess I did. Tejani, just loving all the kindness and care. Oh, thanks. What a magical, beautiful space of softness and expansiveness. My heart is constantly swelling with appreciation. Oh, it's been lovely having you on the retreat, Tejani. Every time I catch you on the screen, I think of, so Tejani and I were ordained together 13 summers ago. So I think of that time that we shared up the mountain. Chittamodini, I find it so helpful in the fourth stage to hear that it would be good to recollect my habits of mind. Yeah, This opened a new door. Fantastic. And thank you, Zach, for dropping all of the links in the chat. So those are there for you as well. So if we could go back to gallery view to say goodbye, and do feel free to unmute yourself or make any reactions, and we'll see you in 4 hours. Go well.
I see you again soon.
See you soon.
Bye-bye.
Goodbye, everybody.
Thank you, thank you, thank you.